So we have the, I can't pronounce this, Trumming Swarm. 7 mana 8/4 when I'm summoned. So if you've leveled a champion, you get to, it's like infinite value, right? This card's pretty slow. I don't see what deck would want to play this, honestly. Initial impressions, I just honestly, like, I don't know. It's a very fun card. It's a very cool card. But I doubt it ends up finding playable. I doubt it ends up finding a home. Like, you, like this card, you build the Trumming Swarm deck and then you kind of like have fun with it. He talked about this in Echo Zill as a control finisher. I think BBG's smoking. I think you've got better finishes than Trumming Swarm. It's got 4 HP. Okay, let's look at like what matchups this deck, like what would make this card good. First of all, like anything that doesn't have like removal, like this is good against slow decks that haven't got a consistent finisher. So I think Trumming Swarm is good against Targon decks. I think Trumming Swarm is bad against aggro decks because you're dying. I think it's good against, it's a little bit awkward against mid-range decks if they play Rally. It's good against Shadow Isles because you have consistent value each turn. I think this card would be actually pretty good against the current Shadow Isle decks because you're just constantly throwing like problems at them. Unless Feel the Rush was like existing, like any deck that has a good finisher would win. Like Karma Ezreal, this card, like Karma Ezreal doesn't care about this. It's too slow. They should make it an exact copy. Making it an exact copy would be a bit busted. Because if you reduce the cost of this, that would be pretty crazy. It's to play around price reductions. I think not even buffing stats on this is a problem. The biggest problem is price reduction. Because if you just kind of like have cards that reduce the price of something and then you kind of just play this over and over, that's kind of crazy. Like imagine it read that and then you played some of the new P&Z cards, right? That would be heaps fun, but yeah. Anyway, we'll talk too much about Trumming Swarm. Artwork's cool though. I'll play with it though, don't get me wrong. If were a 5 mana 6/2, at least you could play two of them in one turn. Yeah, actually, look, if you play it as a one of in a deck, that's where it finds the most value. I think if you build a strategy kind of like around it, that's probably not going to be correct, but okay. I can definitely see how playing a one of is not even that bad. Sure. I think you could find a home in many decks as a one of in Shurima in particular metas. Rhymefang Den Mother. So when I'm summoned, summon a Rhymefang pack and grant it +1/+1 for each time you have frostbitten enemies this game. So like immediately, like I don't know if the payoff for this card justifies running a deck that plays lots of frostbite cards, specifically just for frostbite. You play Ash LeBlanc with like some frostbite support to kind of flip Ash and have a finisher in that way. I mean, ideally, you play a 6 mana 5/5 on curve. You've probably not played many freeze effects because freeze effects are kind of like not a productive play. It's like not something you can realistically do consistently where it makes sense, if that makes sense. Because like you're not just going to go out of your way to like frostbite stuff just so you can buff the Rhymefang Den Mother. That's probably losing you a game most of the time. Tusk Mother. You mean the one that frostbites over and over. But then you're playing bad cards to make another awkward card a bit better. So on average, you might play this as a 6 mana 5/5 summoning a 3/3 with Overwhelm. That's not very good. It's not that this card's slow, it's just that it's not strong enough. Like, don't get me wrong, like, maybe sometimes you'll play this in a super late game, and maybe you've only frostbitten, like, 6 or 7 times, and then you want to play this on, like, turn 8. I think I'd just play Captain Farron instead, right? Right? This is a role-playing card. This is for people that, like, when they play World of Warcraft, they specifically pick the role-playing servers. No cap. Now, Ruined Rex, though. So just so I can clarify this, when Ruined Rex casts the Cannon Barrage, it's only the one proc, right? It's not the entire, like, Riptide Rex proc. Cannon Barrage is the effect of dealing 2 damage to a random enemy, and then dealing the... Yeah, that's pretty much it. So for this card to make sense, I guess you'd want to draw 2 to 3 cards at least. This is probably the reason why they nerfed Rummage. It could be. I need to double check exactly what Riptide Rex reads. Yeah, so see how Riptide Rex says cast Cannon Barrage 6 times? This is Cannon Barrage. I think the only way for this to make a lot of sense is to draw at least 3 cards in the turn, right? I think this card looks good, but it might be an okay card. It requires a very specific setup. Like, your deck needs to be run a certain way. And then you have to have mana up in the same turn, obviously. I think this card could be good. I do think this card could be good. Is this game newbie friendly? Yes. How long does a game last? Anywhere between 10 to 20 minutes on average. Sometimes quicker, depends what you're playing. So in Bilgewater currently, like, the consistent combo would be like pick a card. You play, pick a card. You draw into this on turn 5. I like this in a deck that plays lots of card draw, right? You know, it's you never feel okay. Pretty much, I think if you play this as a 5-mana 3/3 that deals. Like, if you only get 2 procs of Cannon Barrage, this card's not very worth it. You want to be at least getting 3 Cannon Barrages off when playing Ruined Rex, obviously, if not more. Like, anywhere below that just makes this card pretty mediocre. It's good anti-aggro, though. Like, I don't know. It's hard to play. It's going to be extremely difficult to play this card on curve. Thank you for the follow, man. It's going to be extremely difficult to play this card on curve. That's my issue with this. And then, like, unironically, do you know what turns you're roughly going to play this on sometimes? Sometimes you're going to play this card on turn 8 and wonder, why am I not just playing Riptide Rex? This wants to be played in a deck with just tons of cycle, right? So you can try and make it look decent. I'm gonna Omega LOL if, like, half the time this card's unplayable until like turn 7, turn 8. But it has potential. We'll have to wait and see.